has proven himself to be an expert in it. He is a corporate professional with over 7 years of experience across Fortune 500 companies, Fonterra Brands, Unilever Reckitt Benckiser. His experience spans across the fields of marketing and strategy. He is also a renowned lecturer and a corporate trainer with years of experience in coaching and mentoring the youth of Sri Lanka. As a testament to his success in the world of training and academia, Shafraz Saleem was awarded the prestigious World Young Achiever by the Education Congress in Singapore. Everyone, please welcome on stage Shafraz Saleem.
Hi guys. Good evening guys. I'm a little louder than Telina. I think you heard a lot from Telina.
Can you hear me this way? Am I clear? Yes, thank you. Okay guys, so I know it's quite late in the evening. So I'm not gonna really dwell on too many things. I'll just talk to you a little bit of things that is necessary for you, then I'll let you go. I'm audible enough, right?
Good.
Right, I can be loud if you want. So, before we start off, I was told you guys are a bunch of young people aspiring to be entrepreneurs, and that's fantastic, right? That's a fantastic spirit to have. That's a fantastic passion to have. I saw one familiar face in the crowd as well. So the title that is here is Enterprising in a VUCA World. So some people, how many of you know what VUCA is? Can I show of hands? See, either you talk to me verbally or you talk to me using sign language. One of these languages we need to use. Or worst case, do this, do that. But if you are like this, right, expressionless, it can be a problem.
Oh, okay. They'll go crazy otherwise.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to use a mic because it's getting recorded, but I can be very loud, right? So if someone can reduce the volume and make it really low, so that will be fantastic. Right, good. So how many of you know what VUCA is? Can I have a show of hands? Good, that's what I wanted. Because if you already know, why am I here, right? Yeah? So one slide on me, this is not to give myself an ego boost, guys, trust me, that's not the reason. Yeah? I believe whenever someone talks to you, you need to believe them, you need to trust them, that's when you have credibility on them. Otherwise, you sit in the last row and you fall asleep a little because you don't trust the person. So I just want you to trust me a little. So this is my corporate exposure, these are the companies I worked at. Those are the qualifications I lecture for. I'm also one of the shareholders of a college in Sri Lanka called Achievers. Then I have an app as well, another app getting launched next month. So I'm not a typical entrepreneur. I'm a corporate, but I know what entrepreneurship is. Let's put it that way, right? So I'm here. When I was told by the team saying, look, I need to speak on market analysis. That was the topic given to me. Then I told myself, what do you mean by market analysis? I'm here to tell you, forget market analysis. How do you need to know what's happening around you? Now, if you're an entrepreneur, you have an idea. Idea is always great. But the point is, sometimes when you come up with an idea, you fall in love with your idea too much. And you forget to challenge it. So let me tell you, all of you might be sitting here with your ideas, but you need to be open enough to ask yourself, is this that idea that I want at the end? Any of you married here? No? Before you get married, you have many versions of what an ideal wife is, ideal husband is, but then reality strikes, right? Does it strike? It does, okay? I'm married, happily married for 4 years now, right? But that's what happens. So you need to keep your mind open right now through this session saying, look, maybe I might have to revisit my idea. That's what I'm trying to take you through, right? So I've said our world is VUCA. That's what our world is VUCA. What do you mean by VUCA? Our world is volatile, uncertain, our world is complex and ambiguous. These are the four words you can use to characterize the world we live in today, 21st century. If I was talking to a bunch of people in early 90s, I wouldn't have really said do market analysis. Number one, you can't. So I'm not going to today anyways give you any tools because you guys are startups. You can't be spending on AC Nielsen, LMRV, 10 million rupees, 12 million rupees for a quick research. That's not what I'm here to propose. And if I was talking to you in 1990s, I wouldn't even talk about this because the world was not changing. Today, world is going through these paradigm shifts. Right? It's going through these four essence, these four aspects. Trust me, you need to do market analysis. And let me quickly take you through what I mean by this. But before that, your VUCA, this VUCA concept, it impacts your world. Okay? It impacts our world. It hits you hard. That's why we're talking about it today. What do you mean by VUCA? Volatile. Volatile means what? See, in simple English, volatile means changing fast. Do you get my point? So I went on Google sometime back and typed volatility, and I got a physics answer, and I failed physics when I was at school. So I kind of ignored. And I told myself, volatility is where things change very fast. Now, things are changing fast, but as entrepreneurs, why does it matter to you? It matters to you because today when you build an idea, your idea is built on assuming your consumers have a particular purchasing power. You understand? But very soon, because the world is so volatile, because things are changing so fast, our exchange rate value is greater than our Sri Lankan cricket team score these days, right? And it keeps going up and up and up. Very soon, you don't know what your exchange rate in the country would be. Inflation is going up. Venezuela is suffering from inflation. So things are changing rapidly. Your consumer purchasing power might be dead and gone before you know. So world is volatile. That's why you need to keep your eyes, mind, ears, everything open, right? Uncertainty. That's Donald Trump for you. I don't think many people can figure him out, right? Do you know he has 12 cans of Coke Zero a day? Let's hope he dies soon, right? Yeah? So, uncertainty. Donald Trump is just one example. Huh? But today, what's happening? There's a lot of uncertainty. Uncertainty means what? I don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. I don't know what's going to happen day after tomorrow. You guys are working on ideas today. Trust me, by the time you're done with your idea and developed your idea, commercialized your idea, you might face a situation where the entire environment has changed. The problem is the first one, you know, change is happening at speed. Here you don't know what is happening sometimes. It's so uncertain. World is uncertain today. Why? Because of political environment, because of economic environment. Do you get my point? Because of diplomacy. North Korea and US were not talking to each other. Today they're talking. US and China had a decent relationship. Today there's trade war that's happening. Trump slaps a tariff. China slaps a tariff. So uncertainty, what does it do to you as businessmen? It will ensure that your consumers are reluctant to experiment or commit. If any of you are looking at apps, if any of you are looking at business models which is based on subscription, trust me, if it's uncertain, if the world is going through an uncertain time, your consumers may not be willing to make a long-term commitment with you. They might not be willing to make a commitment for the next 1 month. There's an entrepreneur in the US, he's made a business out of making soap in his kitchen, in his garage, and his pantry. And he sells 3 month subscription based soap and ships it on Amazon or sells it on Amazon. But it's not going to happen always. So I'm just giving you thoughts, huh? Not that all of these applies to you, maybe some of these applies to you, right? So remember, things are changing and things are question mark everywhere. So people may be reluctant to commit. People may be reluctant to experiment. Do you understand? Yeah? Next, complexity. This is what it is today. When I was sitting right behind, I saw people taking their mobile phone and capturing picture, not of the number of the slides. And then I told myself, dude, when I was potentially in my early teens, I would write down. There are still some of you like me, right? Writing down. Today people take a picture and then you forget about the picture. When you go home, you never look at it again, but you feel good, right? I took a picture. At least the slide is in my mobile. I will never see it again, but it's okay. I feel good that I'm taking something home. Complexity. Complexity means what? I don't know. There are so many factors that's involved. That's what you mean by complexity. Today, people are not very simple. That's one of the main reasons is because you're always on. You're always on. You're on your mobile, you're on your tab, you're on your laptop. I have a nephew of mine who's 4 years old who's on YouTube. Right? It's become complex. Today's people speak of good carbs and bad carbs. Forget about good carbs, bad carbs. At my 60s, I didn't even know what carbs were. Right? My mom said, everything you eat, digest at this age. That's what she told me. Today, people say, good carbs, bad carbs, protein is required. Right? People say, you need to have this to digest. Protein shakes are required. Whey protein. Lot of things. People have become so complex. So remember, you are creating products, you are creating ideas for complex human beings. Huh? That is why you need to know what's happening around, because people are so complex, people are so knowledgeable. Long time back, if you had to fly to another country, you knew one or two airlines. Today you go online, you get 25 options in an ascending order, descending order. So remember, while you might think your idea is lovely, your consumers are absolutely smart and complicated. So I'm applying VUCA to the consumer, so it makes sense to you, right? Clear? So that's the third one. Oh my god, this is the other one. Ambiguity. This is the gay community. Yeah? These colors. So today, if you look at brands like Nike, Burger King, are using advertisements, are using promotions to say, look, we are not discriminating against anyone. We are looking at everyone commonly. But let me tell you, that's a murky ground to be in. Huh? Some people will like it, some people will not like it, some people will laugh about it. That's the consensus. So today, as entrepreneurs, trust me, some of the actions you take today, some people will like, some people will not like. You don't even know. Uncertainty is different. I don't know what's happening. Here, one situation has two interpretations. Ambiguity, ambiguous. Whatever idea you give, some people will look at it as wow, some people will look at it as no. There's a TV channel, MTV, Indian TV channel. It's only about reality shows. And it's about youth-based reality shows. Youth that are bulldozing the cultural norms of India. And the young crowd love it. Right? It's all about young people. Some parents also love it. Some parents hate that channel. So today, people are very opinionated. You don't know whether your actions are interpreted in the right way. So sometimes when you come up with an idea, you need to think a lot, asking yourself, look, let's look at all angles and all lenses possible. That's VUCA. Now, which tells you a lot of things are happening out there. Things are not sure. People are complicated. I don't know, one situation is interpreted in two, three ways. You're not sure about anything. And in case you have questions, interrupt me because I talk a lot anyways, right? So you interrupt me and just we'll talk about any clarifications. That's what VUCA is. So which means, VUCA is here to stay. VUCA is definitely here to stay. World is going to become more volatile. World is going to become more uncertain. World is going to become more complex. World is going to become more ambiguous. That's going to happen. Now if you want to be corporates like me doing a day job 9 to 5, no problem guys. VUCA is sorted. Why? Your CEO will give you processes, will give you policies, will give you rules, you are through. But if you want to be entrepreneurs, you make your game rules. And you need to maneuver through the storm, always. VUCA is going to be a storm at you. And you need to maneuver. Now the challenge is, but how do I conquer this storm? And how do I become a successful entrepreneur in the VUCA world? It's volatile, everything is happening, but how do I become that? How do you become that? You conquer the VUCA world by being ultra-informed. By not being informed, by being ultra-informed. Know everything that's happening around you so that, not just today, I'm not talking to you about you come up with an idea, launch and whatever, right? I'm talking about you running this business on a day-to-day basis. And if you want to be successful, you need to be ultra-informed. And to be ultra-informed, you don't need to buy research reports. Common sense. Today, online gives you free access to a lot of things. There's an app called Flipboard. Flipboard is a very popular app on iOS and Android. You download, you can put whatever interest you have. If you put entrepreneurship, it will pick up entrepreneurship-based articles from all around the world, put it in your app. It's like your personal assistant who gives you something. You get my point? You need to be ultra-informed. So then I told myself, okay, dude, if I come here and do a bit of preaching saying be ultra-informed and go back home, people might ask me, dude, okay, fine, but how do I be ultra-informed? How does it help? So I said, let's equip you with something. I'll give you a tool. Imagine you have a toolbox. Let me give you a tool. That will enable you to be ultra-informed and take on the challenges of the VUCA world. And the concept I'm introducing to you today is called 5 C's. So whenever you want to brush up your idea, when you're presenting your idea to someone and you want to give that someone confidence that you've looked at everything that affects your business, do a 5 C's. And what is 5 C's? Consumers. Category, customers. Remember, consumers, customers are two different things, correct? Yeah, when you were young, your dad used to take you to a restaurant, your dad was your customer, you were the consumer. He never eats, you eat everything, right? Same thing. Yeah? Competition, and what's the final one? country. You look at all these five factors and that's how you become absolutely informed or ultra informed. Is that clear? So I'm going to take you through each one with examples. I'm not going to, no text, not, I mean you will see very minimal text on my slides, right? It's all visuals, we will talk. Yeah? Consumers. Now when you say consumers, who are your consumers? Anyone, right? Your consumer could be him. Yeah? Your consumer could be me based on your idea. People who are finally going to use your product. Is that clear? Yes or no? Right. In consumers, what do you look at? Number one, I heard this question also being channeled to Kilina, and I think Kilina answered perfectly well. How do you, what do you do with consumers? Number one, understand the wicked problems experienced by consumers. Why do I use the word wicked? Wicked, is it a pleasant word? If someone looks at you and says, you're wicked, will you say thank you very much? No, right? Because wicked is not pleasant. Wicked problems are the ones which gives you tension. Consumers have an anxiety. Consumers are not happy. Wicked is whenever a wicked problem is something that gives you a tension or an anxiety. Understand what your consumers' wicked problems are. Why? Because your ideas must solve the wicked problem. If you want your business to be successful, if you think your idea must be successful, ensure that your idea solves the problem that a consumer has. There's no point you coming up with a fantastic idea which doesn't have a problem. Then you need to create the problem. You need to spend time on creating the problem. Understand the problem your consumer has, create an idea for that. Let me give you an example, some case studies. Samsung blind cap. How many of you are familiar with this? World's best coffee? Guys, you want to go home soon? Don't want to go home soon? I want to. So let's talk. Which is the world's best coffee? Not Starbucks. There you go. A lot of people think it's Starbucks. The world's best coffee is McDonald's. You'll be like, my God, really? That bloody thing? That espresso? That cappuccino? I have that coffee when I don't have much money to go to Coffee Bean. McDonald's is the world's best coffee in the world. See, what do I mean by coffee? Coffee is coffee, right? If you go to McDonald's and have that coffee, it gives you that aroma. It gives you that wake me up feeling. That's what coffee is. Starbucks doesn't give you coffee. Coffee has become beautiful. That's all. Starbucks gives you coffee, milk, chocolate sauce, whipping cream, cherries on top. Where is coffee? Coffee is lost. Starbucks started realizing people were not coming to Starbucks for the coffee, not for the tea. People were coming to Starbucks for the ambience, for the environment. To meet people, to work there, to talk to people. That is why people were coming to Starbucks. Starbucks didn't realize that at the start. Starbucks started inventing new coffee, new tea, coffee machine, and actually forgot to keep space for people to talk also. And you know Starbucks' mission today? To inspire, nurture each neighborhood a cup a day. That's their mission. But you know now Starbucks is changing the mission? You know what that is? To facilitate human conversations. So they are saying, let's forget about worrying about whether you put chocolate on top of cherry or cherry on top of chocolate, you add both together. Let's create space for people to talk. Let's ensure you have good Wi-Fi. Let's create some rooms there. Let's create telecom facilities. Look at how a business changes when you understand consumers. Do you get my point? So you need to understand, is there a problem? People are moving away from Starbucks because you are not creating that environment. That's what understanding consumers does to you. Now that's understanding consumers. Okay? Clear? You need to understand consumers, what problems? What problems? Panadol problems. What problems? What problems? Bigger problems. Correct? Second one. I come from Fonterra, so I need to speak a little bit about my company. Right? Yeah? So, segment consumers on psychographics. See, by profession, guys, I'm a marketeer. I've been a marketeer for the last 6 years. Now I'm in strategy. So, I love marketing-based things. So, that's why this is going. Number two, I think what you should do with your consumers is segment consumers based on psychographics. Psycho, what? Graphics. Not demographics. So, when you put a business plan for your idea, don't say my idea is going to talk to male between the age of 25 to 45, female between the age of 18 to 32, let's say male and female with kids between age of 6 to 12, no way in hell, you're not talking to demographics, talk to psychographics. This is protein plus. Protein plus means extra protein. It's not whey protein. Yeah, it's not that much of protein level, but extra protein. You know how Fonterra Anchor defines this? They don't say male, female, nothing. They say high performers and people who aspire to achieve success through the day. Do you get my point? People who are willing to dispense energy to achieve what they want during the day. Now that might be 18-year-old, that might be 35-year-old, that might be 55-year-old. Today 55s are like 35, 35s are like 15, right? Could be male, could be female, could be a kid who's 12 years old, who knows? And you can't say people with money, people without money, rich, poor. No, 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 it doesn't work. Some people who don't have money will also make money. This is important. So, biggest advice I'll give you is never segment your consumers based on demographics. Do it if you want to, but look at psychographics. Because you can't sometimes divide people on demographics. Demographics is becoming too thin today. Do you get my point? Let's take, for example, AI Asia. AI Asia is a budget airline. Are you telling me it's only people who don't have money who fly with AI Asia? No. So you can't say low income. It could be anyone. So understand, psychographics means what? What is their mentality? That's all. Shape up. Anchor has shape up. Shape up means the one that allows you to lose some weight or low fat milk powder. Can I say young, old, adult? Anyone who wants to stay slim, stay fit. You go to Independence Square, what does it in the evening? You will see 18-year-old running, 35-year-old running, 60-year-old running, 75-year-old running. Sometimes you don't know why who's running, but they're running. It could be anyone. So divide consumers based on what? Psychographics. Is that clear? Yeah? And the final one on consumers, listen to the unspoken consumer word. So this was a brand I used to handle. I used to be the brand manager for Surf Excel at Unilever. So, this is something the consumers told us that we learned. We went to consumers. See, Surf Excel is how much? 285 rupees a kilo. I don't know how much it is today, right? Sunlight was 140 rupees a kilo. Hema's Diva was 135 rupees a kilo. So, some people bought Surf Excel, gave up Surf Excel, moved to Sunlight. Some people have never tried Surf Excel in their life. So, we went to those consumers and asked them, look, why don't you buy Surf Excel? You know what they told us? No, 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 no. Surf Excel is too harsh on my skin. Surf Excel is too strong. Surf Excel doesn't clean. Surf Excel is not good fragrance. All nonsense. You know the real reason? What was the real reason? It is too expensive. There you go. But no one will tell you that. I completely agree with what Tilina said. One of the biggest pain points with apps today is paying by credit card and debit card. Only 10 to 15% of the transactions are done by our card. Everything else is pay on delivery. Now if you go to a consumer and ask, look, why don't you pay by credit card, debit card? That guy will never tell you I'm scared. Because if you say you are scared, it looks like you are ancient. You are like an ancient Roman kind of an era. You want to sound modern. So you say, no, 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 it's just that I find money convenient. But the real reason is what? The tension behind is my transaction secure. Do you get my point? So when you interact with consumers, listen to those words that they don't say. Because that's what you need to create your idea. If consumer gives you everything, what you are thinking today, that guy would have thought yesterday, right? Correct? You don't need to pack your bags and say, okay, let's meet my consumers. Your consumers are all around you. You need to listen to the words that they never speak. Is that clear? Make sense? Am I doing fine on time? Okay? Yeah, good. Is that clear? That's the consumer part. I've told you three things that you need to do if you want to succeed with your idea. Get the wicked problems of your consumers, correct? Divide them based on psychography. Finally what? Listen to the words that they don't tell you. That will only happen if you can dig deeper into what they say. Is that clear? Good, now category. Category means what? Coca-Cola is what category? Coca-Cola is what category? Beverage, right? Not washing powder. Right? Coca-Cola is beverage. That's a category. That's what you're talking about now. Sunsilk? Sunsilk? Sunsilk washing powder. Shampoo. Right? Good. This is my first thing on category for you. Your category extend to adjacent substitutes as well. Remember that always, guys. Don't go anywhere and say, I am Coca-Cola, my category is beverage. That's the normal answer. But if you want to be successful entrepreneurs, that's not your answer. Coca-Cola is category, not just beverage, anything you drink is a competition or the category of Coca-Cola. Look at this. It could be milk, it could be juice, it could be water, it could be energy drink, anything. Today, beverage industry uses a term called share of throat. Not share of market, share of throat. So, Coca-Cola says, I have 80% market share. Okay, example. But I have only 15% share of throat. 85% that goes into your throat drinking is not your product. So, they want 85% of the throat. You get my point? You understand? Yeah? Obviously, right? No one takes a washing liquid or petrol and drinks, no? So whatever you drink, I want to be a part of that. So remember, Tirana was saying, look at the market size. So if you're Coca-Cola and you look at market size, look at share of throat, not share of category. So if I'm Coke, I will tell myself, how much of milk are you drinking? How much of energy drink are you drinking? How much of isotonic drinks are you drinking? I want a portion of that. Today, New Delhi is doing that, flavored milk. Hershey's in India is doing that, Hershey's milk. They are saying, Hershey's is saying, everyone who drinks thumbs up, because thumbs up is the most popular drink in India. Everyone who drinks thumbs up, I want them to drink Hershey's milk. Because at the end of the day, Coca-Cola, what does it do to you? Refreshes you, right? Can milk refresh you? Yes. Today, the fastest growing category in the world is what? Beverage. Do you know the fastest growing category in the world? Beverage. What is the category? Water. And what water? Flavored water? No. Fragranced water. So I'm not giving you flavored water, I'm giving you water, but it smells of jasmine. I'm giving you water, it smells of rose. So the fastest growing category around the world for beverages is fragranced water. Carbonated drinks is crashing. Juice is also not doing that well because there's a stigma around sugar today. Yeah? Today, the fastest growing category is that for water. So your category goes beyond your immediate products. That's the first step, right? So whatever idea you're doing, ask yourself, what are my other products that's similar to it? Is that clear? Secondly, ensure that your category that you select is insulated from external shocks. People who've done econ, you know elasticity. Elastic and inelastic. Choose an idea that will work always. Whether the economy is doing well, whether the economy is going down, whether purchasing power is going up, whether purchasing power is going down, you should have a product which sells big time. And Uber is a classic example. You need to travel. Do you get my point? You might not buy a new shirt, but you have to travel. Travel to work, travel to class, travel to this workshop. So the category you choose, forget about the product, category, your idea, the category it belongs to, has to be something that is frequent. Uber, taxi, whatever, it should be something I want to use all the time. You can't give a product. For example, I'll give you an example, right? Imagine you are thinking of Haagen-Dazs ice cream or Baskin Robbins ice cream, premium ice cream. Good. Then you charge really high because they won't have you all the time. But if you want to be really successful, consider a category which gets used all the time. Is that clear? That's on category. So I've given you, see, I'm not giving you any tools to use. I'm telling you when you look at, think of consumers, think of category, this is what you should think of. Is that clear? Customers. Customers means what? Customer is not the guy who uses your product. Customer is the guy who buys your product so that it gets sold to someone else. And I'll give you an example with customers. What is this product? Red Bull. You know Red Bull became popular? Today, one of the most popular places where Red Bull gets sold is what? Nightclubs. Pubs. That's the most popular place where Red Bull gets sold. You know what Red Bull started doing? Every night, Red Bull team used to go to these places to dance. Not dance, they used to go. And they used to take huge cartons of empty Red Bull cans. What cans? Empty, yeah? Nothing in the can, empty Red Bull cans, and throw it in the nightclub and go home. The morning the owner bloody comes, sorry for my language, I use that all the time, comes to the nightclub and checks, see, there is empty cans of this blue color thing. What is this? Forgot about it. Next day again it happened. Third day again it happened. This guy said, look, my people are not coming to my nightclub and buying anything else. They're buying Red Bull and they're bringing it from outside. I might as well sell it. And they called Red Bull and said, please give me your cans. That's when consumers knew that something called Red Bull. And they bought. What am I trying to get at? Maximize your presence at your customer location. Ensure that whatever the product you're thinking, I know some of you are thinking of apps, but if you're thinking of another product which goes through a channel, ask yourself, how do I ensure that I have maximum present at that channel? This happens. If you take some of the shops, these boutique shops you go to, toffees are there in those bottles, right near your hand, impulse purchase. And after that, you don't want the toffee, you get the toffee because that guy doesn't have change. Right? That's what it is. If you go to supermarkets, if a supermarket has a promotion, if they are giving you buy one, get one free, that will always be in the corner. If Anke is going at 30 rupees discount at Cargill's, Cargill's will put it at the corner. On the way to buy milk powder, you will pass tea, you will pass sugar, you will pass coffee. When you come back, you will have bought everything. You get my point? So ask yourself, how do I take a customer location and create maximum impact? Next, redefine the category placement norms in outlets. See guys, I don't drink, but let me tell you something. People who drink have told me that wine and cheese goes really well. I have no idea, right? And cheese, I'm not talking about happy cow cheese that we are popular with. I'm talking about the aged cheese. Now normally, if you're coming up with a new cheese, you will say, I will keep the cheese at the cheese section. Don't do that. Keep cheese next to wine. Because if wine and cheese goes really well, when the guy comes to buy wine, he will buy cheese. Or when he comes to buy you, at least he'll buy something else. So ask your product, doesn't have to be complementary, guys. What is the other product that your product goes really close with? Keep your product there. Do you get my point? That's what you need to do. So if you think Marmite and bread goes really well, keep Marmite next to bread. If butter and bread goes really well, take butter to a bakery. Think of out of the ordinary. Don't think of the usual way of placing your products with customers. Do you get my point? Yeah? And finally, Intel Inside. Announce yourself at the customer location. So Fonterra is looking at this. Companies are looking at this. Sometimes you know what happens? Let's say you are selling an ingredient for food. Let's say for example, I am selling Anchor cheese for your pizza. I can go to Pizza Hut and say Anchor Inside. You get my point? So sometimes at the customer location you are announcing yourself and suddenly your consumers will think, wow, this is fantastic. So even if Pizza Hut doesn't buy you next time, consumer will force Pizza Hut to buy you. Or when he goes home also, he'll try to get you from wherever he finds. You get my point? Today pizza that you buy from Pizza Hut stretches, correct? Domino stretches. You will have to stretch one person also on the side, the other one from other side, right? Pizza stretches because they use something called Anchor Extra Stretch Mozzarella Cheese, which you can't buy from the market, it's only to restaurants. Now if Anchor can say Anchor Inside for their pizza, some of our other cheese will also sell. So think, wherever you are selling your product, see I'm making it general because I don't know what your ideas are. Huh? But if you are selling your product somewhere, can you announce there that you are available like Intel Inside? Exactly. That's on your customers. Two more to go. Competition. I'll put three brands here. Zomato, Food Panda and Swiggy. Three delivery apps in India. This is something I firmly believe in. If you're not number one, be the opposite of number one. Two, if you copy him in a way where you are better than them, like the Chinese, you know what Chinese do? They'll copy you, they'll be better than you. So if ever you are not number one, I'll give you an example. Nike was number one. Puma copied Nike exactly. They actually brought Usain Bolt into an ad. So they said, like, see, if you take Nike, if I give you two names, Rafael Nadal or Roger Federer, who comes to your mind when I say Nike?
Negative.
Who comes to your mind? Now, don't ask me who's Nadal and Federer. Who comes to your mind when I say Nike? Nadal or Federer? A Nadal, right? Because a Nike is like an aggressive brand. Do you get my point? Yeah, it's almost like get it done, just do it. It's a very ferocious brand. Nadal comes to my mind. But when you say Adidas, who comes to your mind? fairer, more gentleman-like. Do you get my point? So what Puma did was Puma exactly copied Nike. And Puma failed. Why? Because Nike consumer said, if I want Nike, Nike is there. You copy and become a me too, I don't want you. What did Adidas do? Exact opposite. Adidas said, no, 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 I am not Nike, I am gentleman. That's the difference. So if you are getting into a market where competition is already there, don't worry. Be the exact opposite of competition. Today, Pizza Hut and Domino's dominate the entire market. But are there small restaurants that are successful? Pizza restaurant, why? Because they are saying, I will not give you thick crust and all the sausages and cheese inside. I'm giving you thin crust. Do you get my point? Yeah? So always think, how do you become number one? If you're not the number one, be the opposite of number one. Do everything that number one does opposite. Then what will happen? Number one consumers won't come to you. Who will come to you? Others will come to you. Sometimes that is good enough for you to become number one. Because you can move people. Is that clear? That's the first advice on competition. Some more case studies. Look at this. You know Red Bull, right? Do you know this brand? How many of you have seen this brand? V8. Can I show fans? Obviously, you've seen it now before this. V8 is also an energy drink. But the difference is, when you take Red Bull and turn the ingredients page, does it sound like a table of contents of chemistry book? It does look like that to me because I don't understand any science subjects. So you don't know what's inside. But you drink and you feel like you've got wings, right? Yeah? But if you take V8 is also an energy drink. Only vegetable juice, water and caffeine, that's it. Only fruit juice, water and caffeine. So V8 says, I am also giving you energy, but I don't give you wings. I am not cool like Red Bull. I don't send people around in cars with can on top of that. I am not at party places, but I'll give you energy. So I am the exact opposite. I'm a healthy alternative to Red Bull. You get my point? Complete opposite. Now people who love Red Bull, would they buy V8? They would never buy it because sometimes V8 tastes really bad, huh? Because vegetables don't taste good when it's a juice. Some people have tomato juice, carrot juice because it sounds good in public, right? What do you want? Tomato. Yeah, carrot. But it tastes really bad. But who buys it? Others who have a different preference. Others who say it's okay. I don't want taste, I just want good energy. Do you get my point? So that's a case study. This is another one. How many of you are familiar with paperboat? Can I show fans? I know the paperboat you make at home is different. This one, paperboat, anyone? This is a very popular brand in India. How many of you remember this telegram called Malgudi Days? Good, very good. Same music is played in this ad. While every other brand in India were trying to talk about blueberry juice, mango juice, apple juice, lemonade, pomegranate, all these exotic fruits, paperboat said, you know what? Forget about it. I am going to give you products that remind you of your childhood. Chilled rasam, kala katta, which are all Indian favorites. Amras, which is mango, right? All nostalgic, reminds you of the past. Do you get my point? That's what they said. So they said, I am not cool, I am exact opposite. Very successful player in India. That's on that. Final section, I'm moving on to country. When you look at your country, what are some of the things you need to remember? Number one, identify what are the emerging trends in your country and capitalize on. Look at the emerging trends in our country. Is tourism coming up? The only problem is still Indians who are coming and Chinese, right? That's a problem. But tourism is going up. So look at that as a trend. Wow, tourism is going up. I know our currency is depreciating, but that's also an opportunity for some people. Do you get my point? Then ask yourself, Sri Lanka is one of those countries with an aging population, lot of old people. Do we have enough products for older people in our country? Look at the clothes for older people, makes them look old, feel old, everything. Do we have a trendy outfit for older people? Look at the trends that's happening in Sri Lanka. Pick up on that. That's the first one, right? Second, preempt problems that are happening in your country. Preempt potential macroeconomic challenges. You know our president hates sugar, right? Yeah, our health minister also hates sugar. So sugar tax every single other month. Huh? So if I'm Coca-Cola, I should check that. And I should plan for that. And what has Coke done? Coke? Zero. Thanks to our president, Sri Lanka is becoming healthy today. You go to McDonald's, McDonald's doesn't even give you a choice, sir, Coke Zero. Right? But if you want the other Coke, you have to pay extra. So Sri Lanka said, no, Coke Zero is better. Now, if Coca-Cola did come up with Coke Zero, Sprite Zero, everything in time, your sales would have crashed. Today, when you go to McDonald's and if someone buys Happy Meal at McDonald's, you don't get with drink, you get with milk. And what's that milk? New Deal chocolate milk. Why? Because McDonald's realized Coca-Cola is too expensive. So if I am smart, I will know what's happening there and come up with plans already. That's why you need to understand what's happening in your country. First one was trends, second one is the challenges. Is that clear? I'm almost in the final slide now. Understand national issues. What are the issues in your country? This is a Nike shoe. How many of you are familiar with this shoe? This particular shoe? With green around? You know this shoe is made out of plastic collected from the ocean? It's made out of plastic collected from, now don't ask me how because I don't know. It's made out of plastic collected from the ocean. So what they do is they pick up plastic from the ocean that's disposed, convert it into a shoe. Because that's a problem the world is facing today. You don't have to think of the world, think of the problem Sri Lanka is facing today. And is Nike doing it because Nike loves the world? No, Nike loves money. You love the world, so you'll pay money because you love the world. You get my point? So you need to look at what are some of the national issues there. Those are the five things you need to look at if you want to ensure that you sharp focus your ideas that you have today. And I'll end with this quote which I strongly believe in. Today we are living in an age of information. Information is all around you, everywhere. You take your mobile, there's information. If you wish to ignore, ignorance is just your choice. Yeah? That's on my session. Any questions you have? I know I spoke a lot. Any questions you have? Anything you want to clarify? All yours. Happy to answer any questions you have. Anything you disagree with me? That's also okay. Any questions? No questions? Good. Okay. So, in case you need any further assistance, any further questions, my contact details are with the organizing committee. If it absolutely must, you can always reach me. Not a problem. My email address is there. My contact number is there. You can reach me. Would be happy to be your support. I hope you gain something out of this. Thank you.